Hello, in this video we are going to explain what happens when you use brute force features of the PondWireF. So the setup is composed of one PondWireF device, the Android application, one RTL SDR dongle connected to SDR Sharp, and another RTL SDR dongle connected to Universal Radio Hacker. So both Universal Radio Hacker and SDR Sharp runs on two different machines, one Linux and one Windows. So you may have some lags between the two, so there might be some synchronization issue. So I'm connecting to the PondWireF using the Android application. Okay, I'm connected, the LED is blue, and now I'm going to the brute force page. I will choose a chipset, for example PT2260 in the version 10 address bits and 2 data bits. Okay, so we can see that the code word settings are already preset, so we have 12 symbols. I will reduce the frame repetition to only one. Okay, just for debug and for the demo. So the Indian S is big Indian. Function mask and value, it's the fixed part and variable part of the code word, and the symbol encoding are in ternary base, so we can see that there are 3 different symbols, no synchro and a tail word. So now I'm starting the capture on Universal Radio Hacker. Okay, capture is started. And now I start the brute force. We can see a lot of data. The red light is blinking. SDR Sharp show the power of the signals, and URH capture the data. So now I stop the capture, I stop the brute force, and we will analyze what's going on with the data. So let's rename the file to some new name. Okay, we close the window. Okay, we see a lot of data, so I will reduce a bit. We know it's ASK. I will choose to see the signal in demodulated form and in hexadecimal. Here you can see that we have no data, so let's reduce the noise, 0.1. Okay, we have better data. And still the hexadecimal is not good. Let's do an auto-detect. Okay. And we can see a lot of data coming from the PondWireF. And we can see we have some bytes changing. Okay. So the brute force is trying a lot of possibilities until we found the correct one. And you can see here that you have the symbols, so 80, 80, EE, etc., corresponding to what we have put in the symbol encoding. So I hope it's clearer now. Thanks for watching.